Just in time for them to be doing something.
4708.
Not entirely sure what they're gonna go do. Tell you the truth, it looks like Buddy's shutting her down. See all that green? Well, I'm not seeing anything going on. We'll go take a tour of the yard, see what's in storage, and then we'll come back.
There's nothing in here to be loaded. She's completely empty. They probably use this ramp to get them excavators off this cart. See what's on the other side. We got the DT-111 cars that are all stored up here. There's still some fuel stored here too. Oh, that's horrible here. There, that's a bit bad. I don't see anything going on back here. Lots of fuel cars, sorry. Big puddles. There's where they unload all the salt, sand, and chip city. Some propane. They killed these tracks. Didn't bother putting the switches back on. They used to continue all the way through where this building was. Got a tank car now. Way more than there was. She got one of the sand or whatever cars that were back there. I don't even know if they're still there. It doesn't even look like it. Oh yeah, they are. See them out there. Oh, she's getting foggy. Hold on. There, fix that up. RDC is still here. Chilling. Yeah, lots of stored Gore-Tex. Gotta eat. Gotta eat. It goes down a ways. Let's head back. Yeah. Lots of stored cars at OTTAWA now. Which is really what CN should use the city yard for. They should store long-term cars here and sell that. If I bought the railroad, that's what I'd do to make money out of this thing until I got traffic back up. I'd also turn this yard into an intermodal facility. There's lots of space to make that in here. And there's a huge market because there's no intermodal facility at this point. Everything that comes in intermodal is driven in from Montreal. Man, lots of stored cars. This line here, these ones with the whites, they got propane. They got one line of DT-100s, and these are all propane up here, these two cuts. Well, one cut's propane, I think the other one's fuel. It's 1202 or something like that. Headlight's still on, blazing. Get up closer to get a nicer shot. Big bump. don't think they're leaving or doing anything. Just getting ready to tire down. Yeah, it used to be a huge yard. Still got most of the tracks in it. Minus the CP side. The CP side used to be the original CN side. They built the CN side for CN and they kicked them out of downtown. CP took it over when they got kicked out of downtown. Alright, let's get one good picture without that pole in the way. Tanks, some potash. That's so weird, the rear ditch lights were just on. So here's the consist. That's what's on this train. Now the front ditch lights are on. I'm gonna hang out for a sec. Yeah, so I don't know what's up. They're having a break and then they're gonna go and drop these cars off in Montreal. Could be. Maybe they're waiting for the VIA to clear. So yeah, I don't know what's up. Crew's still here. Well, we're still waiting. I'm giving him 5 minutes, and if he's not moving, then we're gonna go. We'll come back later. I just noticed that's a brand new windsock. Floating in the wind. Inside shop lights are on over there. In the old CP shop, well, original CN old CP shops. Which are still basically the exact same. I don't know if they put pits in them or not, or uncovered the pit. There used to be a pit in the far left side. There was an overhead crane there. And on the right side was for MW stuff. And some running lights. It was a decent shop. CP ran it back in the 70s, 80s. Alright boys, I'm gonna get going. Say goodnight. That's the end of her. Call this video. Good night, boys.